Alright, so next location. Disregard where I am. I fast traveled by mistake again, but we want to go to Creek Loop. You want to cross this road, and I believe you want to cross that road as well. Do you? I traveled. I think it's this way. Down here. I think this is it. Pretty nasty little place. I think this is where you want to go. Yeah, this pond. Oh, there's no pond unless we mean this pond. There's another cat, look at that. What? There's a body down here. Archive conversation with Philip and Gina. 439 Eddies. Philip says, hey, did you know I love you? You're my Dewdorp prince. Princess. I won big. Dewdrop princess? Miss calls. Gina writes, in all caps, it is 3 a.m. Have you lost your mind? Philip says, Gina, my dear, chill, chill. I won it all. We're rich. I won a cat. Gina says, what? What cat? In caps again, what the hell are you talking about? Philip says, it's a pure bread. They said, for real, like big money, cat shows, and OMG, he purrs so loud. The guy's drunk. Says, Philip, if you're driving home, stop right now. I'm not letting you in. But I love you. We're rich. Gina says, you're drunk again, you gonk. You're going straight to rehab tomorrow. Philip says, this cat's gonna buy you a new apartment. Babe. Gina says, I'm blocking you. Don't you dare drive here. Door's locked and it's staying that way. Oh, crap. Could have gone better. And there's something else. I think. Yeah, we just want to continue forward. Unfortunately, I can't really be successful in this. Is it this way? Oh, we got a save in there. I was just about to save. It might be this way. How's that? Like an end? Yeah, here it is. Oh, can we repair it? I thought no. A guitar pick and cheese knives. I thought you needed 18 tech to repair this, but evidently it's working. Activate. Louis starts dancing. Unfortunately, he doesn't do the robot. I mean, I guess a robot doing the robot would be a little redundant. Let's see if there's a fast travel around here. Sutter Street, I guess, would be the closest one. We're not going the right way. What am I... What's the white? So I was like, it's white and it turns purple. So I guess we're just gonna follow this.
Fox or not.
Garbage, you can't walk. Well, there's really no way to walk anyway. I guess we'll just keep going, because I only have two left. I just gotta get back to fast travel, because the next two... Hey, hey. The next two are in the Badlands. So we want to go to... Wait, that's not actually the Badlands. Badlands is down here. Found a nomad camp. Wait a second. I'm supposed to find... some kind of desert film set. Did they take that out? I only see Rocky Ridge. I'm pretty sure it's like over here. So now I'm gonna need a vehicle. Oh, you know what? We are out here, so... The beast. Bring the beast! Somewhere over here. It won't even let me. Loud sounds. So funny, it won't let me pin it because it's not a road. It's off the road, so. Gangway! Oh, look at that. That just took off. That was cool. Evidently, this is a place where I killed a lot of people. Or we want to keep heading this way. I don't want to destroy her car. That's the thing. Yeah, we're headed the right way. It's bumpy as hell for sure out here. Alright, where are we? I think we need to head more this way. Probably should go at night. Oh. They don't... Nah. Where is this place? We're looking for like a fire, campfire or bonfire. So we should be able to see that a little more easily at night. All of a sudden, it's loud as hell out here. And the visibility is way down. That doesn't help. Oh wait, could that be it? Awesome. So, this is where you want to go. Oh, now we have the fast... I guess because I didn't discover it. But I've been here. Didn't I kill all those people? I don't know. But you want to fast travel to desert film set, if you possibly can. If not, come from Rocky Ridge. Like I did. Well, these people have a fire in the middle of nowhere. Playing some interesting music. Here are these people. Whoa. Oh! I scanned them and they died. I thought that happened after you read the archive conversation, or the book over there. I got a skull ring from that guy. The final discovery of Luis Torres. A year has passed since we last heard from Luis Fernando Gonzalo Torres, the bold traveler seeking to unravel the secret of a mysterious syncretic cult. I don't know what that word is. Torres first stumbled upon traces of the sect while in Yugoslavia, where he discovered the remains of a fascinating mural depicting dancers of a forgotten culture. However, the scientific community dismissed his finding as a cheap fake and quickly snuffed out any discussion on the subject. One might wonder, why so quickly? Undeterred, Torres continued in his search, which took him to such far-flung places as Mongolia, New Zealand, Peru, and Madagascar, from which he never returned. As he slowly pieced together the cult's international puzzle, he saw it all pointed to a powerful ritual based on trance-like dance, puzzling incantations and sacred offerings fed to the flames. From his final notes, we learn he attempted to perform the ceremony. However, his last words give a mysterious warning. Be careful which one you invite to your fire. Meaning they're dangerous, or they'll just die. Anyway, headed back for the fast travel location to go to our last secret destination. I'm actually just gonna look around here because... Evidently some stuff not looted. This is the desert film set. People not... I'm not sure if someone else killed these. New ad shoot. Rural beauty. Inspire the city. Enjoy the country. I know there's been a lot of feedback regarding the new ad campaign for a pseudo, but I would like to remind you this was the client's decision, and although we might not agree with it, we must respect it. The person behind it is Pseudo's new creative director and son of the company president, Michael Koch. Below, I've attached a statement from Mr. Koch, and I request that you abstain from unsolicited commentary at this time. With the rural beauty campaign at Pseudo, we want to show that exclusive corporate attire need not be bound by elegant design alone, but also by comfort. Focus tests tell us that many of our consumers and potential consumers enjoy the idea of being able to make a visit from their downtown offices and penthouses to their cottages on the outskirts of the city without the need to change into a new outfit or reimagine their wardrobe. So there you have it. We have to work with the direction we've been given. In terms of our new ads composition, let's stick with the format of the model with the car, but instead of a luxury make or limo, we're swapping in a Thornton Colby Butte. Pickup trucks are time-tested symbols of the rural and rustic lifestyle. Our aim should be to capture the genius in its simplicity. Now, because the set is in a more hazardous area near the old racetrack, I tried to work out a single-day trauma team package for everyone. If anything happens, you should be covered. But if you do own your own private firearm, I'd advise bringing it with you anyway. So good luck out there and enjoy the session. I'm counting on your bright minds to find and capture this rural beauty Mr. Koch has envisioned. Clint Walter, your choice, marketing agency. That's interesting. So I guess I've never been here. Just, I don't know who killed all these people. Maybe they're already dead. I mean, obviously they're already dead, but I don't know if you can ever come upon them alive, or if something just random happened out here. So that's it. And you, obviously, you can take these vehicles too. But we're gonna fast travel to our next and last secret. Let me know if you guys found any secrets. I know you can travel out to where you begin the game as a nomad. I'm not gonna bother doing that, sorry. That's one of the things. Alright. We want to go to regional airport. Unless that's someplace else we haven't found. Oh, here it is. Let's say you can climb faster with none. I guess this place, yeah, it used to be an airport. What's up there? Oh, nothing. Hold on one moment. Okay. So from here, go southwest. I'm not completely sure where. Over here? Yeah. Let's take this. Hi there. Actually, for this, let's go to the morning so this we can actually see a little better in the daytime. Because there's no fire here. There's a vault. Okay, that's a really strong fence. Hopefully I can find this thing. First, ask questions later. Octant drone. Well, it's not attacking me. Is it slowing down? Can actually target this thing. I almost got there. Whoop. I gave it a reset. I don't have a warrant anymore? No. Thing's pretty big. I don't remember seeing these things. Border SoCal Patrol. Southern California. Checkpoint. It's I'm not sure where it is. It's somewhere around here. I think I had gone too far. Maybe here? Thank you. peek. Not seeing anything around here. Checking and make sure it's not one of these, well, houses. Not this. Stand by, guys. I'm gonna refresh my memory here. Okay, so according to a map I just looked at, it's like over here. I can't pin on a non-road, but... we'll go over there and then make a left. Not too far off from where I was. It's just kind of in the middle of nowhere, because most everything out here is in the middle of nowhere. I don't think it's that. It's actually a little more north, at least. It might indeed be this. Let's go check it out. See any vault. That's what we're looking for, a vault. I'm surprised those things don't open fire on us. Could it be that? Oh, it's definitely... it's between these two roads, so it's somewhere in this area. Which way am I pointing? Other way. Right? Yeah. It's over here, but maybe a little more east as well. Looks like it might be this. No. this far out, right? That's pretty far out. Hold on 1 second. Oh, I went way too far. Don't know who I just looked at. It's right off the road. So it's back towards the road. Kinda. Here it is. Found it. It's just saving in case of a crash. Can't even scan that thing. It was his 101 on it, but what's that say? Wraiths. Oh, Wraiths 101. Archive conversation with Albert Cole and Gary Epps. Albert says, we're doing a post-apocalyptic LARP. Join us, it'll be fun. Gary says, so what, you meet up and pretend you're like nuclear holocaust mutants or something? Among other things, sure. And it's not so much pretend as reenact. Gary says, uh-huh. Albert says, we already have this new storyline planned out. We leave the safety of Bunker 101 for the first time since nuclear war erupted across the globe. We need to find a hydroprocessor before all the bunker dwellers run out of fresh water. That's the basic, the main quest of the first Fallout game. Okay. Gary says, listen, no offense, but I don't think playing dress-up and running around the Badlands with a plastic pistol is really for me. Like, I don't want to be rude, but yeah. Albert says, dude, it's Nova. Like, a ton of fun, actually. I'm serious. Like, Brain Dance is just a regurgitation. It's always the same story that you have to follow. But here we get to make the story as we go along. Gary says, so that's why LARP is a billion-dollar industry, too. Albert says, very funny, but man, you get to be the actor, become the hero. Gary says, actors get paid. Albert says, at least try it once. I know you get hooked. I'm skeptical. Will Tony be there? Albert says, yep. All right, fine. I'll go. I need to talk to him anyway. You take any real guns out there with all your toys? Albert says, preem. And yeah, same, but we never really get him out. Gary says, because I mean, it is the Badlands. Scary stuff happens out there. Albert says, Gary, just relax and try to let yourself enjoy it, okay? So it looks like, Gary might have decided to use real guns, after all. There's another guy up here. So there it is. There's your Fallout reference. Specifically the first Fallout. I approve. Anyway, be back to the story next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always... Seek adventure.